waiting for a spinner, show you round the wheelie world. Hop on its front, so come along and take a look at Wheelie World. You'll be surprised how good it feels to zoom around all day on wheels so merrily. Oh, whoopee! You don't need a ticket, but we'll take you on for free. And if you see the witch Vanilla, don't be worried, for there's no cause for alarm. Cause we've got Sheldon, who's the dragon, he will keep you free from harm. It's fun at any time of year, so put your wheel in second gear and then hold tight. All right, we'll show you all the sights of Wheelie World.
Fenella, the kettle witch, was boiling. Her toady spies waited impatiently for their orders.
All still, Riley? Now then.
And all she could see in Wheelie World was happiness.
I can't stand all that friendliness. What have you lot done all day? Scram outside, the lot of you. Do a bit of spying. Useless things.
Things in Wheelie World were much better.
Oh, watch it, Ron. There is a speed limit, you know.
Hello, Zuma.
Well, my dear, things really are
gorgeous. You ought to take more exercise, Otto. It would make you feel young again. Hello, Charlton. Isn't it a lovely day? How are you?
Great, Lita.
Give me, wretched dragon!
We have an idea, gnädige Frau. Fenella's book of spells had been thinking.
About time? Somehow I've got to put the spunkers on that spotty lump. Well?
If you could get the dragon here, if you could only get him here, well, we could have him tied up tight, and you'd be happy as a kite. Oh, yes, yes, beautiful book, well done.
Claptrap von Spilterbeans could be relied on for nastiness.
Now, what's that silly dragon up to?
That silly dragon had been chatting. Now he was off for a stroll. He'd never seen the Wheelie World garden before, and he loved flowers.
Oh, aren't they lovely? Oh, lovely.
Oh. Hey, there's nothing like a day in country. Oh, all that fresh air.
Charlton loved gardens and flowers.
Oh, hello. Hey, aren't these flowers pretty?
Ah, sure, these are solid dollars pretty.
Hey?
Hey?
What?
Ah?
What funny things?
Oh, where are you going? Bye-bye. But Fenella's spying toadies were back home telling the witch where Charlton was.
Flowers, eh?
So, thought Fenella, if he likes flowers, that's what I'll use to catch him. I'll lay a trail of the prettiest flowers he's ever seen all the way around the Wheelie's garden to spout all. Oh, I do hate flowers. How can anyone like them?
Yuck! Atung, atung, gnädige Frau, you mentioned flowers, so here's one now.
Gnäck. Ugh, horrible.
From me to you, another flower, to get that dragon in your power, and more until you got a bunch.
I'll bring that dragon back for lunch.
She popped up in the garden. Chawton was still gathering rosebuds, and all Fenella needed to do now was to put the flowers where even he couldn't miss them.
Oh, isn't that a nice one? Oh, hey, oh, hey, bye. Oh,
Fenella was delighted. It was all working nicely nasty.
Oh, hey, up, hey, my gum.
Roses are blooming in Piccadilly, in the hush of the silver dew. Roses are flowering in Piccadilly, but there's never
now for part two of my evil plan.
And the rose lumps is made up.
Spotted toadies and spikers prickly, come to me and let's be tricky.
The toadies and the spikers reported for their instructions and were told not to let Charlton out of their sight, and even have worried.
It is the rose that I keep in a
moment. It's so easy.
Easy.
Roses are blooming in Piccadilly, in the hush.
Sing, sing, ring along, sing, 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 surround him. Yana was a little silly, silly dog. Who, me? Oh, what was that?
Hey, Bardic. Oh, I. Oh, it's you little fellas. Up at picking flowers, aren't they, Gradley?
Wow.
Oh, hello. Where did you come from? Of a flower.
You daft dragon, I've got you now. Now you really are dead.
Oh, it's another of your games. I do like games. Have you a surprise for me?
Oh, you'll be surprised, all right. Big daft spotty lump. Ah, dear. Magic.
Where?
One big end and sprocket loose.
It was about the time that Fenella was firing her spells that the wheelies noticed Charlton was missing. I know he's a bit slow, but he should be back now. Where can he have got to?
Oh, don't ask me. Could be anywhere. Maybe the minister's seen him.
But he hadn't. Neither had the king or the queen.
This is a national crisis. A time when we must call on the young people of Wheelie World.
Right, let's go.
Here, I'm finished me. Speak, manners. Here, wait.
But Zuma was off. He persuaded King Otto and Queen Doris to join the search. Then he dashed back, rounded up the lazier wheelies and charged off into the gardens that lay all round the town. They found the answer. There in the wasteland near to Spout Hall was Fenella and her sneaky spies and Charlton. But there was something very unsinister about the scene and something very unhappy about Fenella.
What, you, that great spotted dragon?
Zuma was astounded.
Well, look at that. Charlton's happiness has beaten the witch again. Look, the townies are laughing and singing. Hey, hey.
How about my little mushroom?
Oh, stop that. Stop that at once.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Floorclot. Join in.
Oh, I'm cutting my what? Ah, I'll have you for this, you great spatty thing, you. Ah, what have you done to my kettle? It's been struck by a rainbow. Oh, you, my lovely, miserable home.
But everyone else thought it was lovely.
Oh, isn't she a lovely old thing?
Oh, it.
Oh, that tickles.
Shinahan, cripple.
Oh,
Christmas tree beyond thee.
Charlton was unchanged, unafraid, and under the impression that it was some sort of singing game.
You put your right arm... That's it, Gradley.
What, you, I'm going mad. Oh, my head, my poor head.
Fenella just couldn't stand the cheerfulness of Charlton. She may have been evil, but she knew she was beaten.
Oh, I'm crying.
Oh, I wanted to know how you did that.
To Charlton's embarrassment, all the wheelies crowded round.
Oh, my God. So I did nothing.
Charlton, my hero.
Oh, wacky thump. Oh, shush, Miss Jelly. Gosh.
As the government, it falls to me to express...
As the king, it falls to me when I've asked the queen if it's all right.
Oh, what about her? Asked Charlton. The little old lady.
Go away, Mrs. Floorcloth. Come and have a nice cup of tea.
No answer. Not from Fenella, anyway. Though the kettle seemed to move.
Heck, said Charlton.
You think it was something I said?
Well, said Queen Doris, she certainly seems to be steaming mad.
Oh, very good, that. Oh, I must tell her that.
And everyone left, just in case he did.
Bye, bye, little lady.